Hey guys, welcome back to another video. It's Crystal here. It's 2021. I'm sure many of you guys have set those big New Year resolutions that you want to accomplish this year. If you want to be a better student, here are the five skills you should have. The first skill that every engineering student should have is time management. It is really important to stake a work and life balance. If you be more efficient with the time, you have more time to do other stuff you like, and hopefully you'll be happier. Try to attend live lectures if you can and pick up the materials you don't understand as soon as possible. Also, when you are doing a study task, try to just really concentrate on it, get it done, get it over with so that you have time to do other stuff. Time management really comes down into efficiency. The more efficient you are, you will have more time to do the stuff you like, for your hobbies, for other extracurriculars. The second skill you should have is communication. Many of you guys might be wondering, as engineering student, why we need to take English and why we need to take technical communication? Well, it is really important for engineers to be able to communicate their ideas clearly to other people and tell people what they want to build, right? So being able to communicate your genius ideas to other people and share your knowledge, it is super important. Communication also comes down to networking, how to approach people, how to approach your employers, your professor, and your classmates. Right now, many of us are looking for summer internships. So learning how to network, how to approach your employers or companies effectively will really increase your chance of getting a job offer. The next skill you should have is team collaboration, being a team player. Engineers usually don't work alone. You're more likely to work with other super talented people. So for example, in your group project, you have to learn how to work together. For example, you're building a cardboard chair. You have to communicate with your team and share responsibilities and decide how to make the strongest chair, for example. Communication is a big part of the team collaboration. For example, if you're working for a bigger company in the industry, let's say Tesla, you're booking a self-driving car. You have all these people coming from a very different educational background together. You guys are working on this project. So being a team player is really about deciding together what is best for this project rather than what is best for you. The next skill, a very important one, is critical thinking. Critical thinking can be divided into many different areas. For example, creative thinking, analytical thinking, and ask meaningful questions, for example. When you look at a situation, you'll be able to find the key problem and link all the knowledge you have learned to generate a solution. Critical thinking can be applied in any disciplines and also in our real life. For example, you're reading newspaper, you see something, you should be like, do I trust this source? Is this source reliable? Is it up to date? Are there any other additional research that I can do to prove this source is reliable? That kind of stuff you should be asking yourself. The next really important skills that you should have is to take initiative, especially if you are a college student. You're paying so much money, you're spending so much time in school, might as well to think how I can make this experience more unique and more meaningful. Taking initiative really means to say yes to the thing that you want to do and maybe to challenge yourself to something that you thought that you wouldn't have tried. There are many opportunities and many ways that you can take your initiative. For example, if you see a classmate struggling with their homework, maybe try to offer your help. If you see some design teams are hiring, try them and apply. Also, if you're doing a project together, you can maybe volunteer to be the project lead, etc. And there you have it, the five really important skills that I think every student should have. That's the end of this video. I hope you learned something useful. If you have other skills that you would like to share with us, feel free to say in the comment down below. I'll see you guys next time.